like so many New Mexico entrepreneurs, I was very focused on my small business and making a really, really great product. But as a company, we just couldn't grow. Again, like so many New Mexico entrepreneurs that do amazing things, it was really hard to reach additional markets. So we took a big bite and said, we're going to invest in HPP. We did a little research and found Avura out of Ohio that makes high-pressure processing machines. And that allowed us to extend the shelf life of Verde Juice. And so almost immediately, within months, Verde Juice got picked up in Whole Foods and in Natural Grocers, Albertsons, lots of independent retailers. Our sales doubled instantly, and our shelf life went from 4 days to 4 months.
What's even more exciting is the trickle effect that will happen with additional businesses popping up, coming to New Mexico Fresh Foods to help them solve problems.
I hope all of you have had a chance to go around and sample some of the wonderful opportunities that we have in the tents here today. And I think that's those samples are a little bit of the sampling of what the opportunities are for the state of New Mexico to really change how we do ag, how we think about agriculture here, the value-added component, how we think about building out those sort of jobs in this state.
It is not easy to start a business, especially during COVID. And we have seen that disproportionately women and minorities have been most affected by this pandemic. So it's amazing to see Kelly up here and her girls come and hug her after this. And I really wish that we could do more LITA deals with mamas and babies. So if any of you are out there who are mothers who want to start a business, please, please, please come and talk to us, because we are not doing enough deals with women entrepreneurs in New Mexico.
As we kept growing, we realized other New Mexico companies like us were probably struggling with similar issues of market access, longer shelf life, ability to get to processing facilities, ability to create distribution for products. And since the barriers were beginning to come down for us, a group of partners got together and said, you know, we should bring this technology to New Mexico. One, it gets you off of the road of having to go back and forth from Colorado. But two, it gives us the opportunity to offer that same technology to small food companies here in New Mexico.
It's exciting to see HPP come to the first, here, be the first toller here in the southwestern part of the United States. What we've seen historically, is, as we open these across the, not only the US, but across the world, we see innovation being driven, jobs being created, new products being developed. So that's really exciting when we talk about economic opportunity. And as Walt just mentioned, even not just here locally within New Mexico per se, but income that comes in from out of state.
So that is what HPP tolling is all about. We bought the big machine. It's 60 tons empty. It's a huge monster of a machine. We partnered with Bernalillo County to convert this facility into the first HPP tolling facility in the entire Southwest.
The other thing is, what this also does is it allows us, to, as a Bernalillo County, to ship product out of the state and sell product out of the state, which then brings money into the state. That's huge. So it's one thing to produce something that we sell and keep money going here in New Mexico, but it's even bigger if you can bring outside money in, and that's what they're doing here. So I'm thrilled to be part of it.
So I just can't thank Kelly enough for doing this. I can't thank our community enough, AED, the chamber, the city, the county. We are all here, and we are all here because we want New Mexicans to be able to keep food on their table. We want them to have a good wage, and we want them to have benefits. And that's exactly what this company does.